President Donald Trump ridicules his Democratic challengers. He spoke to congressional Republicans last night as the Democrats debated. White House correspondent Mark Irons has more on the president's comments. Mark?
Wyatt, the president made some political promises. He says he's working on a substantial tax cut for middle-income Americans. Outside of policy, he called out Democrats by name, and it marked his own return to a city he recently described as a rat and rodent-infested mess.
Opposed to his criticism, protesters mock President Trump in Baltimore, a place the president says has been destroyed by failed and corrupt rule. He joined fellow Republicans in the city who hope to take back congressional power in Washington.
We also meet to prepare for the coming fight because the traditions and beliefs that have made the American dream possible are under attack like never before.
The GOP needs to win back over 30 seats to control the House in 2020. Their political success is closely tied to President Trump's performance in next year's election. He wasted no time criticizing Democratic contenders, including South Bend, Indiana Mayor Pete Buttigieg.
Buttigieg! Do you believe this guy? He's doing a rotten job running his own city. Lousy job.
With Senator Elizabeth Warren now considered one of the frontrunners for the Democrats, the president jokingly insisted he may have begun insulting her too soon.
I hit Pocahontas way too early. I thought she was gone. She's emerged from the ashes. And now it looks like she could beat Sleepy Joe. He's fallen asleep.
Ridiculing his presidential opponents with nicknames like Pocahontas and Sleepy Joe, President Trump was earlier asked if he respects any of the Democrats.
I respect all of them.
All of them?
I respect everyone. Let me tell you, it takes a lot of courage to run for office. I respect all of them. See that? I'm getting to be much better as a politician. You never thought you'd hear that answer.
And the president is responding again to the possibility of his own impeachment. He says he's not concerned. Yesterday, the House Judiciary Committee voted to approve guidelines for impeachment hearings. It is worth noting that Democrats are still divided about moving forward with impeachment proceedings. Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi says, we can't go there until we have the facts. Wyatt?
White House correspondent Mark Irons reporting. Thanks, Mark.